And we've already come 12 hours to go to Dooky Chase's because we heard they had some really good food. I'm glad to be in New Orleans.
You want to put it in the to-go box?
Huh?
You want to put this in the to-go box?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to cover it
though. Oh, you want
to hold? Uh-uh, shit.
I thought you were
whoa. I cannot keep her on
the screen. Oh, I didn't know that. I'm about to say.
Anybody want to sell ice cream to him?
Give me some.
just a little bit for those fans.
Yeah, pull up.
Clamps are already. Yeah, just move them around.
No, that sounds good.
See what?
Straight out the goal.
Where's my shears at? Sorry, I'm just breaking them in half. So, what you do? If you break them in half, there's all kinds of meat up in there. Dig out the ink. Good and flavorful.
About the same age, and that alligator is a little over 6 foot long, probably getting closer to 7 foot. You take from the tip of the nose to the center of the eyes, measure that in inches, that's how long that alligator is in feet. Attack! Oh, he's purring, you heard him?
Good job, come here.
Going away? Yep. Come on. Here's a turtle. Oh, you're trying to get my fingers. Don't get my fingers. That's not nice. Good job. Come on. Come up. Let me pet your belly. Oh. I only went bad once.
Sort of. And then some.
too much on there is because if there's too much fat, grapes will absorb and it makes them greasy. You don't want them to be greasy. First things first, put your bowl right here. To move things around, put your bowl right here. It's the easiest place to do crepes from, because if you're holding your bowl in your pan, you're gonna have a weird kind of time doing it, okay? Bowl goes here. Pan should be nice and warm. I like to call this warm cup. When you hold a warm cup of coffee, cup of tea, hot drinks, you're gonna feel a warmth on your palm. That's what you want your pan to feel like, okay? Everybody's stoves work differently. I'm not gonna be able to tell you an exact temperature, okay? Feel the warmth, nice warmth to it. Now, take your ladle tool, pick up your pan, drop it directly into the center. And we're going to start pulling around. Traditionally, you want to make a circle, but in this class, I don't hinder creativity. So if you end up with a octopus or a squirrel or a flower or whatever design you decide to make, own it. That's yours, right? It's not about the shape. The shape is aesthetic. It's about the thickness. You should have the same thickness across. If one side's all mounded up and the other side's paper thin.
So you really need a crepe pan.
No, you can use any pan you can make a pancake in.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh. Any pan you can make a pancake in, you can make a crepe in. What you want to do is focus on the thickness. The shape comes with that little roll of the wrist. It's just practice, okay? Once you get it all laid out, you see how it's really doughy and the edges are translucent? Mm-hmm. You want the edges to turn white. They're going to turn white and they're going to peel away from the pan, almost like parchment paper, okay? When you see this happen, you're going to shake the pan. Slides free, a nice clean slide, not stutter. Flip it over, okay? You can use your spatula, or I'll show you how to flip it with the pan. It's not as hard as it looks, it's real fun actually, and I got a little hack for it to make it easy, okay? So y'all go ahead and start, I'll come around and help you do it.
More
rice than
that?
She's a cook, man.
I'm gonna do that too.
For real?
Yeah.
I'm saying she's a natural.
Yeah.
You got it.
You know, because you don't even restaurant, so
right.
You can't even
right.
Make anything. How do you eat it?
Come on, let's sit down. Your mama paid too much money.
Ha ha ha.